Hello children, the Tiger King lesson number 2 in Vistas. I think first part I did it quite some time ago, you can see the video. We are coming to the second part of this lesson. Crown Prince Jang Jang Bahadur grew taller and stronger day by day. No other miracle marked his childhood days apart from the event already described. What was the event that took place when he took birth? Do you remember? All the astrologers were there, right? And this boy of just 10 days, he just spoke out from his, he was there in his pram and he just spoke out. And it was really very amazing, very surprising for all the astrologers that a 10-day-old child was speaking, okay? So after that, no other miracle happened, right? The boy drank the milk of an English cow, was brought up by an English nanny, tutored in English by an English man, saw nothing but English films. He was fully fascinated by the whatever was provided to him, was fully fascinated, or you can say by the British, the nanny was British, English cow was there. So that means he had that fascination for the British things, okay? Was nothing but English films, exactly as the crown prince of all the other Indian states did. When he came of age at 20, the state which had been with the court of gods until then came into his hands. Till 20 years he was actually taken care of, and it was all in the British style, English style. But everyone in the kingdom remembered the astrologer's prediction. Many continued to discuss the matter. Slowly it came to the Maharaja's ear. Okay, so now everybody remembered what the astrologers had said when he was born. Okay, they knew that this thing is going to happen, that he will be killed by a tiger. Okay. There were innumerable forests at the Pratibandhapuram state. They had tigers in them. The Maharaja knew the old saying, you may kill even a cow in self-defense. There could certainly be no objection to killing tigers in self-defense. The Maharaja started out on a tiger hunt. The Maharaja was thrilled beyond measure when he killed his first tiger. He sent for the state astrologer and showed him the dead beast. Okay. Now, when the people were gossiping about his death, that this death is going to come. Okay, because it was spoken by the astrologers. So when he heard all these things, he thought of killing the tigers. The tigers are going to become the reason for his death. So he thought that he should kill the tigers. So when he started killing the tiger, when he killed the first tiger, he called the astrologer to show him the dead beast. Okay, and the Maharaja knew and he felt and he believed that if for the self-defense you need to kill a cow, even that won't be punishable. It is not a wrong act. Okay. What do you say now? He demanded. Your Majesty may kill 99 tigers in exactly the same manner, but the astrologer drawled. But what? Speak without fear. But you must be very careful with the 100th tiger. What did the astrologer say? He called the astrologer. And what did he say? You may kill even 99 tigers, but your life is in danger from the 100th tiger. Okay? So this was the thing which the astrologer opened up. He really was afraid to tell this thing, but when the king said, just speak out what you want to say, so he spoke up that the 100th tiger will become the reason for your death. What if the 100th tiger were also killed? Then I will tear up all my books on astrology, set fire to them, and I shall cut off my tuft, crop my hair short, and become an insurance agent. The astrologer finished on an incoherent note. So he said, this thing cannot happen. You cannot kill the 100th tiger. The tiger will kill you. And he says that if this thing happened, the Maharaja said then, if this thing happens, Then he said, I'll get cut my tuft choti, right? He would get his tuft cut and he will burn all his books of prediction, okay? And he says that I shall cut off my crop my hair and short and become an insurance agent. What did he say? What will he become? An insurance agent. Coming to the third part. From that day onwards, it was celebration time for all the tigers inhabiting Pratibandhapuram. Now after that, it was a celebration time for all the tigers in Pratibandhapuram. The state banned tiger hunting by anyone except the Maharaja. Why it was a celebration time? Because the Maharaja had told all the people of his country that nobody is going to kill the tiger. If the tiger is to be killed, it will be killed only by the king, because he had to complete the score of 100. He needs to kill 100 tigers. A proclamation was issued. What is proclamation? It is announcement. Okay. A proclamation was issued to the effect that if anyone dared to fling so much as a stone at a tiger, and his wealth and property would be confiscated. Now, what was the proclamation made? That if anybody in the country throws even a stone on the tiger, his property will be confiscated. It will be taken away. The Maharaja vowed he would attend to all the other matter only after killing the 100 tigers. Now the Maharaja was very busy because he had to meet the target of killing the 100 tigers. Okay, and he said, and any other work belonging to the favor of, which is favorable for the country, he will attend only after killing the 100 tigers. Okay. Initially, the king seemed well set to realize his ambition. Not that he faced no dangers. There were times when the bullet missed the mark, the tiger leapt upon him and fought in the beast with his bare hands. Each time it was the Maharaja who won. The problems definitely come whenever you are going to complete any work. Okay, so as we people face problems, even the Maharaja felt the problem. Sometimes he missed the aim and the tiger jumped over the king. So king had a fight with the tiger, and definitely the king was the winner every time. Okay. At another time, he saw his danger of losing his throne. A high-ranking British officer visited Pratibandhapuram. He was very fond of hunting tigers and fonder of being photographed with the tigers he had shot. Now, again, the problem was there. The British ranking officer, he was very fond of killing the tigers, going for hunting and killing the tigers. So once he came to Pratibandhapuram and he wanted to go for tiger hunting. And the king told, I cannot send you for tiger hunting. If you want any other animal to be hunted, you can do that, but not tiger hunting. Okay. He refused permission. I can organize any other hunt. You may go on a boar hunt. You may conduct a mouse hunt. We are already for a mosquito hunt, but tiger hunt, that's impossible. Okay. The British officer's secretary sent word to the Maharaja through the Diwan, and the Durai himself did not have to kill the tiger. The Maharaja could do the actual killing. What was important to the Durai was the photograph of himself holding the gun and standing over the tiger's carcass. Carcass means the dead body. Now the very important thing was that the officer, the British ranking officer called as Durai, he wanted his photograph to be clicked with a gun in his hand and his foot on the tiger's carcass. Carcass means dead body. But the Maharaja would not agree even to this proposal. If he relented now, what would he do if other British officer turned up to the tiger hunt? Because he prevented a British officer from fulfilling his desire, the Maharaja stood in danger of losing his kingdom himself. So now it was a danger for him, because he told a British officer not to kill the tiger, and he was actually in the danger of losing his throne. The Maharaja and the Diwan held deliberations over the issue. As a result, a telegram was dispatched forthwith to a famous British company of jewelers in Calcutta, sent samples of expensive diamond rings of different designs. Some 50 rings arrived. The Maharaja sent the whole lot to the British officer's good lady. The king and the minister expected that Durai Sami to choose one of two rings and sent the rest back. Within no time at all, the Durai Sami sent her reply, "Thank you very much for your gifts." In 2 days, a bill of 3 lakh of rupees came from the British jewelers. The Maharaja was happy that though he had lost 3 lakh of rupees, he had managed to retain his kingdom. So now what happened? So because he never wanted to allow the Durai Sami to come for the hunting, so he had bought, you know, from a very famous jeweler in Calcutta, he bought the rings. How many rings? 50 rings of diamond he took, and he had sent it to the Durai Sami, okay? And he thought the lady will pick up just one or two rings from that, but she kept all, and the telegram was dispatched that thank you very much for the lovely gift. So 3 lakh rupees he had to pay, the king had to pay to the jeweler, but he was happy that at least he could save the tigers from being hunted by the Durai Sami. Okay, coming to the fourth part in next video, otherwise the video will be very long. Thank you so much. Love you all.